What's good, my people? It's your boy, RL. What a morning. What a day. But I want to talk to you about one word. Choices. Choices. I have to go to the word. So the scripture that I want to read is from Genesis chapter 2, 15 through 17. And we all know the story of Adam and Eve. God created this beautiful garden for Adam and Eve. I can only imagine what he had in this garden. Animals that we never heard of, plants that we've never seen before, colors that would blow our minds. He also planted some trees in there. So many beautiful trees. But there was one tree, the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. God said, don't eat of that tree. Now, what am I trying to say? God gave Adam and Eve a choice, one choice. He didn't pull their arm. He didn't drag them across the garden and try to make them obey his commands. He just gave them a choice, and they had to choose whether they were going to do right or do wrong. God gives us a choice. And he gives us a choice because he wants to see if we are going to love him. In John 14, verse 15, God says, if you love me, keep my commandments. So he just wants to see if we love him. So let's bring this home today. We're on our job. We have friends, family, relationships. And we all have choices that we have to make in life. In moments where we have to decide whether to do right or wrong, we have to choose to do right because God just wants us to keep his command. I encourage you, all of you, to get in your word and find out what God's commands are. And I know that God commands us to love, love, love because he loves us. So when you are facing trials and dilemmas and circumstances that are hard to choose, you have to choose in that moment that I'm going to do the right thing. I'm going to serve God with my choice. So if someone says something wrong against you, stabs you in your back, persecution, anything that causes discomfort, in that moment, you have a choice. You choose to love. Maybe you have an addiction, pornography, drugs. You smoke a lot. You can't get rid of that addiction. God gives us a choice. Are we going to choose to get into that addiction? Or are we going to choose to honor, serve, and obey him? Now, I understand the enemy's job as well. Just like the serpent in the garden. He came along, slithering, like a little snake that he is, and tried to distract Adam and Eve from following God's commands. And that's what the enemy does today. He tries to distract us from obeying God and doing what is right. I just encourage you to get in his word daily. Get on your knees daily. Pray to him. Ask God to give you a new heart. A heart to serve him. A heart to get in his word. David said, thy word have I hid in my heart that I may not sin against thee. I love you. God bless you. Be encouraged. Remember, the choice is yours. Choose ye this day whom you will serve. As for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. Peace. It's RL.